Welcome to this training video for the Icon Microprocessor Knee. Our goal is to provide training tips for walking with the Icon Knee that will make it easy for both you and your patient. To begin, let's review the recommendations for bench alignment. First, determine the appropriate heel height, then determine the appropriate amount of socket flexion. The alignment reference line bisects through the knee center, the midpoint of the distal pyramid, and 1/3 heel to 2/3 toe lever of the foot. When establishing bench alignment, ensure that the knee is vertical. The knee should not be tilting forward, which would allow the user to meet the forward tilt requirement too easily. During static alignment, the reference line should fall between 0 and 10 millimeters anterior to the knee center and 1/3 heel to 2/3 toe lever of the foot. It is important to note the compression of the extension bumper at the knee as well. This bumper should be compressed so that the knee is meeting the full extension parameter. Now let's take a look at the swing initiation requirements. The following are required to initiate swing. These three requirements must be met within 1/10 of a second. 1. The knee is fully extended. 2. There is active forward rotation of the knee leading up to full extension. And 3. There is an anterior tilt of the knee. Here you can see the three requirements have been met. The user is reaching full extension, forward rotation, and anterior tilt. Swing initiation should happen consistently and feel effortless to the user. Let's review that again. Here are some best practices for walking with the Icon Knee. Oftentimes, when the user initiates swing too easily or has trouble releasing into swing, it is because one of the swing initiation parameters have not been met. Let's look at some examples. If the user initiates swing too easily, check the location of the load line. Ensure the knee is vertical at mid-stance. It should not be tilting forward because that means the user is meeting the forward tilt requirement too easily. In this case, the load line is too far anterior and should be moved more posterior. If the user has difficulty initiating swing, an alignment issue could be preventing them from meeting the full extension parameter. First, check the location of the load line. Ensure the knee is vertical at mid-stance. It should not be tilting backward because this means the user will not be able to or will have difficulty meeting the forward tilt requirement. In this case, the load line is too far posterior and should be moved more anterior. Other examples of alignment-related issues that may lead to a user not meeting full extension include insufficient socket flexion, excessive foot dorsiflexion, or a foot position that is too posterior relative to the knee and socket. Evaluate these criteria to determine if an alignment change should be made. Other factors that can lead to difficulty initiating swing include gait timing issues. This can prevent the user from meeting the active forward rotation and anterior tilt parameters. The user must take purposeful steps within the timing parameter, ensure that they are sufficiently loading their prosthetic side to meet extension and anterior tilt requirements. Ensure the user has received proper gait training. Turning on the alert tone in the training mode of the Stride Studio app provides confirmation to users that they have successfully triggered the knee into swing and can be very helpful to inexperienced users. In summary, it is important to evaluate the three parameters for initiating swing and whether the user is meeting all of them. Is the knee fully extended when the user reaches terminal stance and is ready to initiate swing? If this is a challenge, it could be alignment related or gait related. Are active forward rotation and anterior tilt of the knee happening within the time parameter? If not, this is most likely related to gait. Congratulations! You have completed the training video, Training Tips for Walking with the Icon Knee. If you require additional support, please contact College Park. In the United States and Canada, you can contact College Park directly by phone or email. Outside of the US, please contact your local distributor for immediate assistance.